When you think about the entertainment business, most people think there's a lot of money to be made in the movies. But take a look at the record industry, where one hit can be worth millions. The music world is tough and competitive, not the place most parents would like their kids to grow up in. Well, teen recording phenomenon Tiffany is doing just that, and her mother isn't happy about it at all. The pop voice, the fresh face, the red hair. All Tiffany trademarks. But it is her phenomenal success and her age, sweet 16, that has made her the idolized role model of the teen set.
Do you remember what it was like the first time you heard yourself on the radio?
Mm-hmm. I started laughing. And I didn't hear the introduction. I just heard the song. I'm thinking, this song sounds familiar. And then I started to sing the actual lyrics. And I said, oh, this is me. It's kind of cool.
Apparently, millions of others thought Tiffany's songs were kind of cool. Her debut album, Tiffany, has sold more than 4 million copies. She knocked Michael Jackson out of the number one spot with one of her three top 10 singles, I Think We're Alone Now. So at the tender age of 16, Tiffany is a rock star. Teen dreams don't get any better than this.
When did that dream start, and how did you visualize that dream when you were little?
I started singing around the house when I was two. And I started actually saying I was going to be a singer when I was about seven. I started singing in front of people when I was nine, as far as my mother and my stepfather took me around to start playing with different bands. So it was something that I just loved to do. And I was lucky enough that my parents decided to help me with my dream as far as getting me started to sing in front of people. And then I met my producer and manager, George Tobin.
I told her that that I'd make her a star.
Is there a way we can go out here or something? We can throw one of them out here?
Tobin is a tough veteran record producer. He recognized Tiffany's talent, and at the age of 14, he signed her to an exclusive 7-year recording contract, which entitled him to more than 50% of her record earnings. He also signed her to an exclusive management contract for 20% of all other earnings.
I wanted to make her a multi-platinum artist and somebody with a very long career.
Two and a half years ago, Tobin produced Tiffany's first album, and then he sent her out to make her name the old-fashioned way, one radio station at a time. She did interviews with the DJs and got them to play her songs. She also went out on tour, not in nightclubs, but in malls. Malls are where kids hang out. Tiffany sang, they bought her album.
First couple malls that I did, I was embarrassed personally. I was like, you know, it was a neat idea, but to actually do it was something different. But after a while, it was a lot of fun. You know, and I got used to it, and people started to get the hang of it.
The strategy worked. By the fall, Tiffany was on her way to becoming a star.
This has been number one now for something like, oh my golly, it's been number one for 18 weeks in a row by your request. It's Tiffany with I Think We're Alone Now.
Hollywood Hamilton is an LA radio personality. He was one of the first to play Tiffany's music.
Yeah. The whole success is George Tobin. So it's the same thing. George Tobin is doing the exact same thing that the idol maker, Bob Marcucci, did with those guys, Fabian and Frankie Avalon. George Tobin's doing it with Tiffany.
I said all she had to do was listen to what I told her to do, and I'd make her happen.
You chose the songs that she would record on her first album. Mm-hmm. You developed her style, you cut her videos. Mm-hmm. What image were you trying to create for this girl?
Just real simplicity. Somebody with a real good voice that was non-threatening to anybody. That a girl could take to a concert with her boyfriend and not worry. A mother could take her daughter and say, and wouldn't think it'd be a bad thing to grow up and be like Tiffany.
The all-American image was working until 2 months ago when Tiffany's mother refused to sign a new management contract with George Tobin until it was reviewed by independent lawyers. Tiffany is still a minor, and her mother's approval of her contract was required. Tiffany balked. She then sued her mother for emancipation, asking the courts to declare her an adult and have her mother removed from all of her business affairs. Janie Williams is now fighting her daughter in court.
Basically, to begin with, he has her brainwashed, you know, is what it amounts to.
You feel George Tobin has brainwashed Tiffany?
Oh, definitely. That's the only word I know how to use, you know. He's got complete control of her. His influence over her is, you know, she looks up at him just like he's God. And it's scary.
Do you think that George Tobin is ripping your daughter off?
Yes, basically, yes. The contracts, you know, have got to be renegotiated. They are not right, you know, the way they are. I mean, Tiffany is not getting, you know, what, he has all power, and he's getting a lot more share of the money than what, you know, he should.
How much money has Tiffany made?
Herself? I don't really know.
She's a millionaire, though.
Yeah.
How much money have you made off Tiffany?
I don't know. But just records. There's a couple of million dollars around there, but when the smoke clears.
So you've made a couple of million dollars off of this hunch that you had 2 years ago?
I hope to make more.
How much more do you think you can make?
With good records? It's endless.
Did you think you could make millions of dollars when you signed her at 14?
I wouldn't have done it if I didn't.
You know, there's been a lot of publicity about this case, and a lot of people say that maybe Mrs. Williams is doing this because she wants more of Tiffany's money.
Oh, yes, I know. I've been accused of that, too.
You know? Is that true?
No. My only concern is protection of my daughter.
Your father, when there was love.
Tiffany now lives with her paternal grandmother. Her paternal aunt is her temporary guardian, and her mother has been removed as a trustee of her record royalty account. Neither Tiffany nor Tobin would discuss any of this or her emancipation battle pending the outcome of litigation.
And my mother's my mother. She should still know what's going on. I still talk to my mom. It's not like there's no hatred going on. It's not as bad as everyone makes it seem. And that's why I think a lot of times I can laugh things off. It's just like, this has gotten so out of hand. My mother and I love each other. We just don't agree with each other. There's a big difference.
Okay, we're ready on the left, we're ready on the right.
Hearts are good for. So while the court battle over Tiffany's future proceeds, the Tiffany music show goes on. This week she went into the studio to record her second album.
Be treated like a kid. I don't, it's just something that I don't want. You know, I want to be treated like they know that they're dealing with a person who has a head on their shoulders.
Tiffany's legal problems may have forced her to assume the responsibilities of an adult, but her phenomenal success has made her a teen queen. And at 16, she is already the success she always dreamed of being.
On June 1st, the court will rule on Tiffany's request to have her mother removed as her legal guardian. So far, there's no court date for her emancipation hearing. But regardless of when it is, her mother says she will fight it all the way. There will be more of Sunday Today from Moscow and from here in New York. But first, a short break. Stay with us.